That new Kiki exclusive, y'all. Hot, fire,
H-Money.
Let's go.
I did it all for the first time. Ooh. Made a mistake, but I remind. Yeah. I broke it on a one time. Well, I did it on my way. Fixed it on a front line.
Hey, y'all, it's Girl Talk Time. It's your girl, Mericha and Italia, in studio. We're so excited for our conversation today. It's Girl Talk Time. 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 Yeah, he really should come and talk. He should. All right. Sorry about that, y'all. We had to kind of rewind and come again. But I think according to my technical support, I think we should be good now.
Awesome.
I think we should be good now. We should be unfrozen. Our sound should be good.
Yes.
Dalton, let us know if we're cooking with gas.
Hey, Lisa Wallace is tuned in, guys.
Okay. Hi, Lisa Wallace. So we're so excited about today's conversation. Yes,
ooh,
we are.
Child, I can't wait to hear what these men got to say. I can eat a lot of clarity.
Listen to me.
I even bring my Coke for them. Cause
you bring your Coke.
What?
Well, I had a smoothie this morning. I was being a good girl. I have a smoothie for breakfast this morning, and I have some oatmeal.
I needed a Coke this morning, guys.
So I'm being a good girl this
morning. Yeah, oatmeal and green smoothie. Your body's going to be happy.
Yeah, my body's going to be very happy with me today.
Yes.
So, oh, gosh.
People are tuning in, guys. It's going to be hot.
Yes.
We want to hear what these guys got to say today.
Hi, Kizzy. Lon says we're good on his end, so he can hear us clearly. He can see us. Great.
We need to hear from Lon.
Yes, we do need to hear from Lon.
Lon,
so here's what we want to do. Let's make sure we set this situation upright. If you would like to call in WhatsApp, give us your opinion, whatever it is you have to say, whatever it is you want to say. As if we welcome females and males to this conversation. We welcome both females and males to this conversation. So you are welcome to call in. The number is 825-5433. 825-5433. You can send us a WhatsApp message. You can call in. Mm-hmm. We would love to hear your thoughts. 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 I'm going to say it one more time. One more time.
We want to hear from you.
We want to hear from you, or else we could just be going off on our own.
Give me that number again.
825-5433.
WhatsApp us. Let us know your thoughts, what you're thinking, how you're feeling, your experiences. We want to hear from you.
825-5433. 825.
Should I say it again? 825.
5433. 5433. I'm saying that because we're getting ready to start this conversation based on our female opinion. And so,
I know, right?
And so we're hoping.
And you know, we're never wrong.
We are always right. Always. Always right. Never wrong.
Never wrong.
Never wrong. And you know, we specialize in pointing out that we are always right and never wrong. And we also specialize in telling you where you are wrong.
Yes, Malika, 825. 5433. Thank you, Malika.
So here's my first burning question. Based upon our preparation for this show, Italia, this is my first burning question to the males out there to respond to Lon. Lon says he will attempt to answer our burning questions. So here's my burning question. Why do men, how do I want to word this? So either you could do it or you ain't gonna do it. Jesus.
I believe the answer to every question right now is their ego. It's just their ego.
Like either you are gonna do it or you aren't gonna do it. Why tell me you're gonna do something and you don't do it?
One thing I've learned about men, they will never tell you no.
What? Just say no.
No.
Don't avoid me. Don't not answer the phone. Don't. I don't have a response for you right now. And all that you know, Lord.
They're going to need to answer that one.
Live on radio, Mericha. So all the other mess that happens, like all the other excuses that you make, why not just be, how about this? Allow your actions to line up with
Your word.
The words.
Jesus.
It's not really.
Be a man like, of your word.
Is that really a hard thing to do? Like, is it really?
But guess what? In some twisted way.
Complicated. Like, is it really that hard? I mean, like, help me out here. Like, you know.
I feel like in some twisted way, they feel as if they're being a man of their word. If they tell you that they're going to do something and don't do it, and they'd rather not.
How? Explain to me how.
Because they would rather not. They would rather not tell you.
Know?
Right. Than, because that's admitting that they're unable to do it and they're not a man of their word. They're not going to admit it. It's like, it's almost like they say when you catch them, right, you got to touch them or hold them down, but you can't tell them that's them. They're not going to admit. They're not going to admit. I need Delton in here, man. Who was our first guest? Who was our guest?
Lauren says, we have good intentions, but we don't always follow through. He answered so nice.
I love good intentions.
Yeah, Delton, you need to get in here.
No, I can't accept that from Lauren. Lauren, I'm not going to accept it. Because right now, if someone comes to me and tells me, Natalia, I need you to go and pay a bill for me, and it's $500, and then I can pay you back maybe a week later or whatever. Yeah. I got you. You know I got you.
Oh, my gosh. I hate
you
that.
You know? You know you have a busy day today. You know you're not going to get it. And furthermore, you know you don't have $500 on you. Your best bet is just, don't tell me good intentions, because this is important for me. I really, really need you to do this thing for me. It's important. Tell me, no, I can't. I wish I could. I wish I could help you. Then string me along.
I know this is not what men need to know about women. This is what women need to know about men, right? But I just like to drop a line in there in support of my sister. Everything is important when we bring it to you. If it wasn't important, we wouldn't bring it to you. Like, if we could handle it ourselves, we also wouldn't bring it to you either. So if we come to you and we ask you to do this thing for us because we need your assistance, yeah, is because we actually, like, really need it.
Like, because if I can do it myself,
I just do it. I let you know it's done. You know, yeah.
I don't need good intentions, Lon. I need somebody who's going to deliver. Deliver. Because guess what, Mericha? We deliver every time.
Oh, my gosh. The baby. We deliver the baby. We deliver every time.
I mean, even before, Mericha, I mean, from a single perspective too now.
Yes.
Even, I mean, talking marriage. I'm talking about even in these relationships.
You're right.
We deliver. Yeah. We hold up to our side of the bargain. You know what I mean? We're there. We're supportive.
I think somebody's slogan says we deliver like dominoes. We deliver like dominoes. We deliver. At your door, hot, fresh, and ready.
I know.
No, that's what we do, for real. Like, so help us understand. Help us. I would really like to understand that.
I mean,
Lord, I hear it. I hear you say your intentions are good.
Mericha, I know, but women who would, like, put down their family, put down their girlfriend just to get a call. Oh, he need.
Wow. That's a good point.
Oh, he need. And they would drop every single thing.
To go deal with that.
To deliver. I tell you.
So why they don't drop it for us?
Why they think? Why does it
but
that?
But they don't drop everything for us. How come they don't drop things for us? How come we drop things? Maybe we should stop dropping stuff for them.
Maybe we should.
Maybe that's what we should do. We should stop dropping
Delton
stuff.
Delton's like, oh, Lord.
For them, because they don't drop, apparently, they don't drop things for us.
Dwayne Elton Rose. Guys, don't just do that.
Guys, don't just do that to women. Tell them they could do something and not follow through. Why women making it seem like it is specifically for them and it disqualifies them as a person worthy of a great relationship.
I don't know which mic that is. That's the one.
Do we accept Dwayne's comment?
It should be that one. Okay. No, tell him we don't accept it. It's not accepted. Tell him it's declined. Tell him it's declined. I would like an answer to that question. Why y'all just tell people y'all can do things and y'all don't do it, babe?
Are you serious?
Besides good intentions, because y'all will be the very ones when we're dealing with another male, y'all will be the very ones who will tell us, don't just look at a man's potential, look at his actions. Y'all like to tell us that. Especially the male friends. Wow, Delton, that looks like that really does not want to be a friend today.
Not at all.
Especially the male friends in my life, they love to tell me, you know, stop investing in potential and look at this man's actions, and his actions will tell you what he's really about. So,
sorry, Dwayne E. Roll. That was meant for Dwayne.
A-Roll?
Yeah,
Dwayne E. A-Roll.
Okay, I know. But I just want to know, how come we need to look at another man's actions, but the men that are in our lives who don't follow through, we ain't supposed to look at theirs? Answer that one for me, Delton.
Say the question again. Good morning, Bahamas.
Welcome.
Oh, everybody.
Welcome,
Mr. Delton Roll to Girl Talk. Woohoo!
Yay!
In the hot seat.
If he was sitting in the chair, he would have played some sound effects. But this is girl talk. This is not
no sound effects. No explosions.
No. This is not the morning drive. I would just like to slip this in here. I just like to let y'all know that Delton is actually like a real legit DJ. And if you're having an event,
don't do this.
And you would like to have some really, really hype entertainment, really? You should really consider him because he's really good at it. He just doesn't do it.
And sticking with y'all theme.
He's so good at it.
I'm not going to tell you I'm going to do something and not do it. I'm not going to DJ.
Have I asked you?
I don't like it. I don't like doing it.
No? Mm-mm. Okay.
He's so good at it, though.
Hey.
Why did I get out of here?
Because
man, I don't tell you things that I'm not going to do.
Oh, so then you're saying. That it's not. Let me choose my words wisely. You are not a real man if you say something that you don't do. Is that what you're saying, sir?
That's what I'm saying.
My God.
I believe, as I jump into this conversation that y'all having, I think one of the, this is my personal belief, that as females, you attract a certain kind of man.
Oh, Jesus. Why are you coming for me this morning, Doug?
And when you continuously see in this cycle in your life, I don't think it's the men.
You think it's the woman?
Yeah.
Now you're back to blaming us again?
I'm blaming.
They blame us.
I'm blaming. For everything. That's not a blame. That's just the reality. Because, I mean, you looking at your subset is sort of limited in the men that you have interacted with. Mm-hmm. And so...
So you're saying to me that as a woman...
Men is this. You can't say men. The men that you have known. And I'm sorry for those men, whoever those men are.
I guess we said it because we had the stories across the board from so many different women, you know, who say, well, yeah, I'm having the same issue. You're always promising you do something and you never do it. So, you know, so I guess we figuring this is some type of common trait.
That's your friends.
Common trait.
That's your friends.
Man.
Y'all keep on dating to see your people?
Man, no man.
There are some men that I know who fit that description. And then there's men that I know that don't.
Mm. Where they at?
I mean, there's one here. If I tell you to do something, I can do it. Mm-hmm. One thing I don't do, I don't give you times. Because I know it can take me long.
Right.
So if you ask me when I can get this, steady boy, I ain't sure, but I'm going to do it.
Right.
And I'm going to do it.
He's absolutely right. He does not give you a time, ever.
I don't give you time.
You will try to get a time out of him, and you will not,
But that's
ever.
One thing I do notice about men, you know, as far as if you ask them to do something, you know, they don't want you to put, I can call it pressure.
Yeah.
Because, you know, women, we want it done now.
We want to know where to place our expectations.
It's sort of dark. So I brought a light.
So I don't have a light?
No. I brought my own light.
Oh.
Because you're a little dark.
Yeah,
you're
dark.
That's powerful.
Wow.
Yeah,
man, I don't like that kind of
pressure. Okay, I want to go back to something else you said, Delton, because you said that, hey, Kevin's tuned in. Maybe Kevin can speak to some of this stuff, too. You said that if as women we find ourselves dealing with the same issue with men on a consistent basis, even though it's different men, you're saying that that's what we're attracting?
Yeah, I think so.
So it's not because the men have poor standards?
I guess I would say some. I don't want to, when you come to generalization, it's sort of iffy to do that.
Right.
I think it's just you just keep on finding that same strand of men, or the same strain of men, whatever it is. I think every man has the ability to do, and I think the woman can pull it out of him. I don't believe that every man just the way he is.
So if he doesn't do based upon the request that we make, does that mean that we are not the one to pull it out of him? Is that what you're saying?
Yeah, or maybe it depends what the request is. Give me an example of this request. Any example of the request you have to think of?
Well, let's use the one for this morning, for example.
Yeah, okay.
Like, let's just say there was a male friend that I have, right? Mm-hmm. And I asked him to come on the show. Mm-hmm. And he said, give him an hour to think about it. And then when I called him back, he didn't answer the phone. Let's just say, hypothetically, you know, that's, you know, the scenario that we're dealing with. Now, if this person needed something from me.
Yeah, no.
Okay.
Give me an hour to think about it is no.
Why?
I mean, you're like, if y'all do the same thing. We have ambiguities. We have these little ambiguous statements that we make. And you can determine, how are you doing today? I'm good. That's what y'all are saying. It's a lie.
I'm good.
Lies.
When you ask me how I doing.
It's a lie.
When you ask me how
what's wrong? Ain't nothing wrong. It's a lie.
I don't do that.
Why you see something wrong?
Something's wrong. I know something's wrong. What's wrong? Nothing. You lie.
But you know what's good? What to
give me an hour as an excuse. That isn't it. I ain't gonna.
I don't do it. Wow, this.
That's a money thing. Babe said you're on the way. I need $500. I need $500. Mm-hmm.
Okay, I got you.
That's like, but 2 weeks before I go away. A week, I say, babes, just reminding you.
Right.
I'm going to need that $500.
Need that little thing.
Mm-hmm. 4 or 3 days before I go away. You know I'm going away a couple days, so you won't forget me, eh? No, I got you.
Right.
The night before you go away. Come on, my flight first thing in the morning. I hear from you. I see you.
Because you know, babe, it's like fly first thing in the morning.
I'm trying to get a change in the U.S. I didn't get a change in day.
Motto.
No, that's...
So now you can put it on my bank account.
Yeah, man, I can send that. I can send that to you. I can put down your card.
Jesus, Lord.
I can put down your card.
And then when you go check the account, how much? 300.
That's plenty. 250. I can say a strong two. I'll give you a strong 200.
Oh, my God.
That's happens.
It happens.
But, I mean, I don't want to say that I am, like, some strange guy, but I won't do that to you.
No.
If I don't
give me the 500,
yeah, but see, if I don't have it, I can let you know. Like,
Delton, from the perspective of females, and I'm pretty sure every other female will agree with me who's watching on the stream or listening to the radio, you are not normal.
I am not. That's why I didn't want to come on the show. I am not typical, I guess, the male that y'all interact with.
No. This is interesting. Lon says, we hate for you to hear no from us.
I tell you that. I know that. I figured that. And why, Lon? Tell me why. Why?
Because as a man, I want to be there for you. I want to be the provider. I want to give you what you
even
want.
Even in a fake world.
Even in a fake world, because at that time, then you look at me and be like, I can't depend on you for $500. I won't go, you can't depend on you for $500. No, I don't want to tell you no.
Ego.
So I can try. I can try my best.
It boils down to what y'all think about yourself. It doesn't have anything to do with how we're gonna be left
how
feeling.
How they are perceived.
Because back to my hypothetical situation, the person didn't want to tell me no, but now I consider you as a man who doesn't keep your word.
Truth.
So now I will not ask you for anything ever again.
Ever again?
Ever again.
I remember your last show. You don't like forget. I remember that.
Yeah. No, like, I ain't asking no more.
I remember your last show. Because you got to forget.
I am not asking anymore.
Something might have come up.
Because, no. I told you, I have trauma. I have trauma. I have trauma.
Something came up, emergency came up.
No, because if you needed me to do something and I called you, you was going to answer your phone. Or on a regular day, when I just needed to reach you to get some information from you, you was going to answer your phone.
And if that's the case, then give me a blighter style or something.
No. No.
If every time you call me, I can answer. And then today, I ain't answer. Something came up.
Let me inform you what females is do. And if y'all females out here don't want to admit it, here's what we do. We'll call you. You don't answer. We're going to drive by.
Turn the stalker. Y'all gonna
we're going to drive. Yep. No, we're stalkers.
I have done the stalker thing. I'm
we're not stalkers.
Lie.
We're going to drive by to see where your car is parked. This.
And it works.
We're going to drive by. Is your car parked? Your car is parked at your place, your establishment of work. Okay?
Uncle James.
So that means you won't get no car accident. That means ain't nobody dead.
By the way, do I work in?
Ain't nobody car there. Only you at work. Nobody else there.
I understand.
You just didn't answer the phone.
Someone is asking a question. Dwayne is answering again. What would you do if you have a man who tells you no? Women don't make the alternative easy for a man. We don't make the alternative easy.
Either way, it's not going to be easy because we want what we want and we want to get our own ways. It's true. But here's the thing.
I'd rather you be honest.
You end up in a worse situation. Exactly. You end up in a worse situation when you're dishonest.
Yes, be honest. Yeah.
You end up in a worse situation because then what you do is you break our trust with you. You break our trust. So if you tell us, okay, let me think about it, and then you don't follow through or you just don't do it at all, now we hesitate to even invite you to do anything for us or ask any questions or even consider like you as like somebody that we could rely on. And then you wonder why we rely on our girlfriends. It's because when we pick up the phone and ask our girlfriends, listen, I forgot to do this thing.
True, buddy.
You on the road? Can you do this for me? We're like, yeah, girl, I got you. And then you wondering like why we dependent on them. Because, no, just
they
be honest.
They are dependable.
You might not like the response that we're going to get when you tell us, no, I can't do it. We can row. We can fuss. We can have plenty to say. But at the end of the day, you're going to be honest, though.
But we don't want to hear that, though. We don't want to hear the row. We don't like...
You're going to get row anyway, though, Delton.
Yeah, but at the time, I don't want to give you a response that's going to make you row me now.
Or you rather defer it.
Like, listen, I don't want to say no to you now and then. All of a sudden, you know what? Thanks. The one time I needed you, you can come through for me.
Because you know that's what's coming.
Please. Like, I don't have it. I honestly... Yeah, no, all right, fine. But if you want to go away with your friends, you would find $500 to go away with your friends. It's like, this is too much.
Lawn
so you know
sake.
What? Yes, I can get it for you before you go away.
So you know what I want to hear? I don't want us to focus just on negative.
Okay.
I want to give us some good. Give us some of the good, the bad, and the ugly. Give us some good things that we need to know about men.
Lawn says, we may not have the $500, but we will be your Superman in case of emergency.
Right away.
What?
That's what he says.
Something happened to you in the States, we got you.
But that's the emergency.
No, that $500. That $500 is you go to the Max door. You know, emergency.
First of all, Delton,
makeup emergency.
$500.
Sorry, I don't know. That's all I had in mind. I was going to go Flory Roberts or Fenty.
Oh,
I don't know.
Fenty.
Just
all say right. Sephora.
Yeah, he was going to Sephora. That $500 was Sephora, and for you to go down by Rainbow.
Dwayne, be honest, okay? That's our answer to that. But give us some good, though, Delton. Give me some good things. Some good things we need to know about you, man.
But men,
being hopeful.
Yeah,
I think a lot of times. What men really want is one to be appreciated. What? We want that our advice is wanted, and when I give you advice, you actually listen.
Okay,
don't move too fast. So the first one is
so let's say there's you're in a situation in your life, and then you don't like you wouldn't even come to us. I'd like be like bring it to us to hear our opinion on it. Or if you come to us with our opinion, you just really wanted to just pass the time. You don't really care what we have to say. So you bring something else just to say, like, all right, you know what? If I don't tell him, he can be mad. So let me just tell him anyway. When my decision is already made.
Interesting.
So why are you asking me this?
So you're
not going to take heed to what I have to say.
So then you're saying, Delton, that if we're having a conversation with a male in our lives, we should probably preface, I'm saying this to you not for you to fix it, just for you to listen.
You can preface that. However, it's our nature. We're gonna try to fix.
Yeah, because I ain't gonna lie. I don't like that. I don't like when I bring something to you and you try to fix it. Because I don't want you to fix it.
Like
I just want you to listen.
Once you bring something to us, any problem, we don't. Your girlfriend's is the listening ear.
Oh, so I shouldn't talk to you? Is what you're saying?
Yeah, when you bring a male a problem, that's for us to fix. Other than that, what you bringing us for?
So I don't talk. We don't talk.
We can talk. But when you come to me, like, tell me what you think about this. Or let me tell you what happened at work today. And this really made me mad. So, all right, this made you mad. Here's what you can do to make sure this don't happen again.
No sympathy, empathy.
No, there is, but at the same time, I want to make sure it don't happen again. Because this girl's making me mad every time I ask her to do this. All right, you finish talking, I'd be okay. So that's what you do. Next time, don't go to this girl. Stop going to this friend or this friend every time, and you leave from there, you upset, you come home, and you bringing this to me every day. But how this girl make you mad? How this boss don't like you? Mm-hmm. All right, that's good after the first time. All right. So what we need to do now is how to fix it.
Lord, if y'all see these messages coming in
every day.
Because
right
you don't hear this every day.
Why am I hearing this every day?
That can drive you crazy.
Why am I hearing this every day? Wow. That means that you are insane. You do the same thing every day. And then you don't want me to say that? I'm going to say and be like, oh boy, that girl, she is something else.
So, shout
this is interesting.
Sheffield Wallace says, I handle small problems. You can make noise all you want. I can ignore tremendously.
Wow.
Lauren says, yes, I prefer to be the fixer than the listening ear.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Anonymous comment says, well, if that's the case, I want you to fix the problem with my wallet before I go away. I need that little thing.
Thank you.
Fix that. And that's literally what they said. Fix that.
That's not a problem.
Exclamation point.
That's not a problem. Now, is that wife or that's girlfriend? That girlfriend, I ain't fixing the problem.
Yeah,
I ain't fixing no wallet problem for a girlfriend. I ain't fixing that. I could be nice to you and give you something to go away with, but no. And then if it's a wife, I don't have to fix that because you have access to my money.
Ooh, sir.
I'm talking
if it's a wife, I don't have to fix that wallet
that's
problem
what I'm
because
talking
we
about.
We share the same wallet.
Delton, you're holding it down.
Okay, so Delton, you know what? This is eye opening for me because there are times as females, right? Let's just tell the truth. There are times as females where we want to come to you with something because we know that you can, that we can trust you because you're going to keep it.
Mm-hmm.
We don't necessarily want you to fix it. We want to talk to the person who's the keeper of our secrets.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And so is there any way, like in a man's psyche, that he could perceive that we don't want this thing to be fixed, that we want to speak to our keeper of secrets and we just want him to hold this?
There is a place where that happens. I can speak personally. There's a place, dealing with my wife. There are certain things that I know she doesn't come to me, and she just wants to get it off her chest.
Right.
And those things, I just allow her to talk.
Okay, so we can do this.
But what happened? Let me know how we get. How I get there. I get there because I realize you keep on coming back with the same thing.
Yes.
And even after I've tried to help, I realize, okay, this is not a problem that you want help with. This is something that you comfortably just deal with. But it's bother you every time. But you want that. You want that.
Because sometimes the situation is such. Because if it's your boss, who is like overbearing and just being obnoxious and being an issue for you, you really can't address it the way you would want to.
No.
I mean, really.
Yeah.
You know.
Without getting fired.
Without getting fired.
Yeah.
Exactly.
And,
so
and
my
need our jobs during COVID.
Yeah.
So my recourse then is to vent to you.
Yeah. No. Some of that. That's understandable.
Yeah.
You can't really. I can't help you fix that. Because the boss can be a boss.
But then you have them girlfriend issues too that you could talk to.
But we still don't do that.
No.
Because some girlfriends, you know, I just ain't gonna tell them certain things.
Right.
I just deal with it or I'll talk to my husband about
right.
it.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
You know?
And he'd be like, so you could deal with that? I'd be like,
no. I just gonna leave it alone.
Yeah, I just gonna leave it. So I have a question.
I see why you're saying
I have a question. Are y'all like that as males? Let's say if y'all have an issue, do y'all just deal with it? Do y'all just fix it? Y'all just attack it? Y'all don't leave it?
If we don't fix it, it depends on the issue. For me, I have corners in my brain.
Yeah, I heard that men compartmentalize a lot.
Compartmentalize a lot.
Y'all don't. They don't mush things together.
And so
interesting.
I have a problem with Mericha. Mm-hmm. I take Mericha's problem. I say I don't like how Mericha talks, right? But I have to interact with her every day.
Mm-hmm.
So for me, I'm going to try to fix that and try to tell her to talk about. I can understand this is how Mericha is. So I take that part of Mericha, I put that in the corner over there.
Interesting.
So okay. I don't like
something. There was a time I believe Dalton really didn't like how I used to talk.
Yeah. I don't like how Titi does this. Or I know Titi don't like me, but she still comes to the office and smile every day. All right. So I know that's the way it is. So I'm going to accept it for what it is, and I put that in the corner over there.
We don't address it.
Mm-mm. I will adjust myself.
So
for how you feel about me,
do you filter through that? Do you filter through that compartment at all? Do you filter any interaction through that compartment?
No, I don't. I just I accept it for who it is.
You see how different it is?
So for me, I can know you don't like me, and that doesn't change if you walk in here and say good morning, and you bubbly.
Yeah, good morning.
No, I bubbly back to you, and I'm not holding any resentment in that you don't like me. I know you don't like me, and that's just the way it is. Like I say, this doesn't. I wouldn't dare say this is all men.
Right.
So for Delton, that's just who I compartmentalize. I put things in corners. And
Lauren says, we fix the problem as it becomes a priority. That's interesting. Because, you know, women are the complete opposite.
No, y'all want to dress.
We don't function. We not only can we not function, we filter. We filter everything and we don't compartmentalize.
You see how she said good morning? She only said good morning to her. She said she look at you and she look at you and she said good morning. She didn't look my way.
Yeah, listen,
I have the poor child evening, like tune in.
And we don't separate, we don't compartmentalize. We amalgamate everything together. So we look at the last interaction that you had with us and this current one, and we measure both of those interactions, and we think about the interaction from last week, and we think about how things were last year, and then we think about how things were 5 years ago. And so we compare all of those things, and so that's why when we come to be like, you remember that time 5 years ago, and da 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 da, like
pull the whole filing cabinet.
Yes, like, that's because where does file come from? That's how we are, and I could say that broadly. No, and knowing that there might be some women who are not like that, but I can say that broadly because I've had enough conversations with my girlfriends to realize that, like, no, we like that. We pull files.
Yeah.
We pull files. We think about everything as a whole. Mm-hmm. We don't mm-hmm. separate mm-hmm. stuff.
We do.
So your no in a situation, which is probably why y'all don't say no.
Because y'all file that.
Yeah, no, we file that.
Y'all file that no. That no also says to us
that you have the ability to deny us, and we don't want to believe that. Mm-hmm. And so we will apply that to another area. Even though it was no about money, we're going to apply that to
anything else.
Anything, actually. Something as simple as asking you to mow the grass.
No, mow the grass. Take out the garbage.
Take out the garbage. Yeah, and you don't do it. Also, now you ain't giving me no money. Now you ain't taking out the garbage. You just don't want to do nothing I ask you to
nothing
do.
Nothing for me.
Wow.
But that's how we are, that's though. Crazy. That's how we are.
What else do we need to know?
I ain't gonna fix that. That's a detail where I don't. That day I gotta fix it.
What else do we need to know?
I think that if that there's a big one. I think a lot of females.
The fixer thing.
The fixer thing of being appreciated, wanting our advice, listening to our advice when we give it.
Mm. What does it look like for a man to be appreciated?
If I do some things, like, I acknowledge it.
How do you want to be acknowledged as a man?
Just to say it. Same way if you get a hair done and you come home, like, you want me to say, like, oh, you changed your hair. So if I hang up something in the house,
That's what you're supposed to do, though.
What am I supposed to do? Hang up something else? That's right, yeah. I don't know.
See, this is eye opening.
So what I supposed to do as a man? Give me a list.
This is eye opening.
Understand why I say that, because this is our house. This is our home. I shouldn't have to acknowledge or show any appreciation for you hanging up your clothes.
My clothes are something. Clothes is different. But I meant like a picture. No?
So you can thank me for washing the dishes, cleaning the bathroom, mopping the floor, wiping on the cupboards.
It depends.
Ironing your clothes.
It depends on what we established from the beginning. My wife doesn't clean bathrooms. I know that from before we got married. Wife don't like cleaning the bathroom. So if for some reason she cleans the bathrooms, I acknowledge it. Because I know she don't like cleaning the bathrooms.
Well, yeah. In that instance, I do the same too.
Okay.
Because there's some things my husband does not like to do. When I see him do it, I'm like shocked. I'm like, whoa.
Yes.
Babes, you okay? Thank you. I really appreciate that.
Yeah, okay. But your first response is, are you okay though? That's your first response.
Because it's shocking.
And that's the bottom right there. So I got to do this for you?
Because
your first response is to be like, something wrong.
What
you want?
What did this be like? $500?
Oh, you want something? That's usually what it goes to. We do something there.
That's something, eh?
You want something?
Wow.
I just zoomed. I decided to, you know what? Let me.
Ain't happening in my house.
I get a lot of private messages. Everybody, these men are saying they agree with you fully, Dalton.
Hey, awesome.
They agree with you. Help me understand this, because you know the way that females like to be appreciated is very different from males, right?
Mm-hmm.
So we would acknowledge something, but we also know that it's the way that we acknowledge it. Like, it's just like how you talked about it just now.
Yeah.
It's the way that we acknowledge it. So we would kind of make a comment about it instead of just highlighting the actual action and saying thank you for it. So are you saying that you don't want the commentary? You don't want our, I guess you could say,
sarcasm.
Sarcastic.
The sarcasm is going to
go. Hyperbolic response. What you're saying is you're saying is you want us to just say thank you, because Shakara is saying they want something. LOL. LOL.
But that's something that Shakara.
They want something.
But that's something we want.
Right? So, oh my gosh, these comments are crazy. Sheffield says females can go back years to pull your file. Leave the past behind you. I guess you're talking to us.
Mm-hmm.
I guess you're talking to us. So what does appreciation, like, how does a man really feel appreciated? Because as females, when you compliment us, believe it or not, I hate to say it because it's kind of like breaking the female code, but words alone will do it for us if we feel like it's genuine. Words alone, seriously, you don't have to do anything.
You're right.
Words alone, if we feel like you're actually like being intentional and you mean it,
mm-hmm.
we'd be like, oh yeah, mm-hmm. like he means what he's saying.
Yeah.
So are men the same way?
Same way. It has to be once it's genuine that you know what, like, I feel like you really appreciate it, and not just like thanks. Which I think we get a lot of time. Is the thanks
and the rollout like I do now?
Yeah. but I think once it's genuine, you can, like, you know what?
Right,
oh wow!
Right.
I go, wow, thanks. I didn't expect that. Yeah, that's appreciation.
Okay.
Again, the number to call is 825-5433. If you want to send a message, the number, same number, 825-5433. Sheffield says, ooh, wow. When it comes to the home and cleaning, I hire a maid. Kill the argument.
That I know, right?
That you have to clean the house, cook, etc.
Chef, everybody like you, chef. All of us, right? we don't own limousines and drive fast right. people around Sheffield.
Lon says a meal makes him feel appreciated.
Oh, food.
Mm.
Hey, Sandy.
I see that with my hubby too.
Sandy is listening from Anguilla. Hey, Sandy.
Yeah, but I mean,
let me tell
food
you.
Don't do it for you, doesn't it?
No, because I keep conflicts. It don't matter.
I
know what.
You could eat hobby, one flakes.
Let me tell you, if I really want to get my hobby good, I shouldn't be setting out all my tricks, though.
Yeah, I don't know all the tricks. Hey, listen, though, you're good. You can help somebody.
Yeah.
Someone listening who need help.
Listen to me. Come home.
Thank you, Shakara.
And cook a nice, decent meal. And I'm talking about let him bathe and then, like, take up the food and serve it to him, like,
oh,
and
give it to him. Oh, you're having
a... Yeah.
Wow.
Loves it. Loves that kind of attention. Loves it.
Well, Italian's not like you need to go and cook.
Well, I mean, for you, I think that fits in that mold of something that's like so random, because you're always busy.
Who, me? Eh?
Yeah. So you don't expect you to do that. So that's why for him it's like a
special thing.
Oh wow! Like, you actually wasn't doing somebody's face. Oh, well, in some class.
You actually took like, time what? Out
you
for
actually
me.
Came home and cooked.
Like, wow.
So,
okay.
So that makes it special.
And I'm a good cook, just so you know.
Yeah. What? Listen to me. What are the two words you used to do?
Oh, my corn chowder.
Listen to me.
So, I have another question, Dalton.
Yes, ma'am.
Kind of tied to what we was talking about, but not really kind of tied. Why do men lie?
Ooh.
Do you need a scenario?
Built in the DNA.
You can give me a scenario.
But I know you can answer this question.
Yeah, man. You know we're talking about, Dalton. You ain't got to explain nothing.
Why y'all is lie? Like, if you cheat, why you lying about it? Like, if you have a whole child, why you lie about it? Like... Or
half-truths.
Something
lies.
As simple as if you we married, our money is shared, and you take the $400, and I can see it was you who take the $400, because only me and you got the card.
Yeah.
So if the $400 gone and I ain't spent it, obviously you spent it. So why you lie? Why do men lie.
like, a special creature.
Like, I just, that's the part I don't get. What's with the lying?
Again, I can't answer that.
Lord Jesus.
That's why I told you I'm not a good person for the show, because I don't.
That's fine.
And the ladies are in my DMs with the lies.
You don't deal with that.
No, I hate lying.
Man, look here.
Whoa.
From any side, I can't stand.
Me too.
Just say it. Get it over with. I don't like the lion.
Can you pretend to be one of your male friends?
If I can pretend to be it, the lion is goes back to the first thing where I don't really want to hear you when you're the talking start.
Hold on, now that I have to push pause here, because Sheffield say, don't answer that question. Black men don't lie.
Archie, we don't lie. Archie.
Black men don't lie, Archie. My God.
I think the thing for us is, one, we don't like the confrontation. We don't like the arguing. We don't want the back and forth.
Yeah, Lauren says the same thing. Because
then, again, when it's come to this, it could be something simple, but we know y'all can pull the files from back then.
Yeah.
My God. I mean, it really irks men that much to hear women talk.
Because a talk ain't just talk. A talk is grabbing stuff back to throw in the face.
What about the Bible say, like a woman, like,
a woman's wrath? A woman's scorn it is?
Not scorn. No, they talk about a woman rowing.
Or they say it's better to live on the roof than to live with a cantankerous woman. Cantankerous.
And that's true.
Yeah, Lon says they lie to prolong the confrontation.
There you go.
Wow. Yeah.
Sheffield says they bend the truth. It's not a lie. It's a bending of the
so
truth.
So they bend it as well. Yeah. They bend it, they leave out, they lie.
And then we leave out. I answered enough of the question to give you an answer.
Yeah. Yeah.
I don't answer all of it. Like, you answer enough. So that you could be like, okay.
Nicole says, but it would be worse when the truth comes to a head.
Yes.
Yeah.
I had some interesting comments here.
Deal with it right there and then.
Oh,
get it out.
Apparently, there is a man in my inbox saying that they believe that women are the biggest liars.
Oh, they are.
And Vera says that is here. So true. That isn't that a human that problem, is true. Though?
We ain't generalizing no more. This is true.
Men's that reasons are true. Different.
Wow.
No, we lie.
Thank you, Marisha.
We do. Now, here's Marisha. The thing.
Now, whose side are you on? Are you on our side or their side?
That is true.
Atalia, you know this for me. You know that I hate bashing men. I hate that, actually.
Mm-hmm.
I hate men bashing because I feel like we're not fair. A lot of times. I feel like we don't create an environment for our men to actually be men because we bash them so much.
Okay.
So in this case, I have to admit, as women, we lie. And we like to justify the reasons that we lie. And then when we approach them and find out that they lie, we don't want to accept their justification. But we like to be justified in our reasons why we lie.
Because most of the times we just be justified.
Exactly. Exactly.
Hey, because we're always right and they are always wrong, right?
Of course.
But I will say this. I don't know what it's like to be married. You two are married. I'm not. But I will tell you this. It is very rare for a female to say a real female who, I have to preempt this. A female who's saved, sanctified, filled with the Holy Ghost, and is intentional towards the man that she's with, I believe it's very rare to find a female who will constantly lie to that man.
They lied about.
Because I don't see a reason for it unless there is, you know, something else going on. But here's what I will say. I will say this. As a single woman, I lie a lot. Lord, I'm on the radio saying I lie. But I do lie. And I, because here's the thing, I'm the person that believes that a lie of omission is still a lie.
Mm-hmm.
A lie of omission is still a lie. Men, a lie of omission is still a lie. If you omit information, it's still a lie.
If you didn't ask the right questions.
No.
If you didn't ask the right questions. It is not my fault.
Of omission.
Wow.
It's still a lie. So as a single person, there are things that I omit. And because most women I know look at a lie of omission as still being a lie, then I would have to say, yeah, there are things that I don't tell the truth about as a single woman to the man that I may be interested in or interacting with them because I don't feel like you need to know that right now. I don't feel like that's your business. Even if you ask me a question and we get to know one another and I don't feel like I want to let you into that part of my life right now, I probably could lie. Instead of saying to you, I don't really want to talk to you about that right now, or I don't think it's the time yet, or I really, like, I don't want to come right out and say I don't trust you to tell you that information. So I'm probably going to lie about it.
That's what you're going to say, though.
No. No, because then what does that do? That shuts down the getting to know what, like, automatically, like, well, what are you talking to her for? She didn't even want to tell me nothing about herself. She don't trust me. She ain't even trying to trust me. So that kind of shuts down the whole thing. So what I do is I lie. Vera says we all lie for the same reasons. Since we told that first lie. Since we told that first lie about who did not eat the cookies or steal the meat from the pot. Oh. Humans just lie. Women and men alike. Everyone lies, so we even.
Everybody. Whether it's a white lie or black lie.
Like a lie of omission.
Lie of omission. Everybody lies. Bend the truth.
It's just.
My gosh. It's amazing. Humans.
Yeah.
It's
like,
wow.
I believe women still are worse at it, though.
Oh, we worse at it. Y'all better.
No, I mean, like, we don't say worse. Like, y'all it's just.
You mean we're better at it?
Yeah, okay, then. If you want to say it's better.
Yeah, we're better at it. I mean, because lying's not good, but I feel like we lie and we don't get caught.
No.
Whereas, y'all don't lie good, Delton. What's up? You know why they don't lie good? Let me tell you why they don't lie good.
Do our research, too.
And then we go back to the good stuff.
We don't have to rely on them because we know they're going to lie.
Here's the thing.
So we say, you know what?
He actually showed us why they don't lie good. They don't lie good because they compartmentalize. That's why they don't lie well. Because if you're trying to deceive somebody, you can't separate things. You have to amalgamate everything. If you're trying to deceive someone, oh, y'all, but you looking at me like you'll never try to deceive somebody.
No, no, no. I listen to you.
All right. Don't leave me hanging out.
No, I got you.
Don't leave me hanging. So if you're trying to deceive somebody, you have to remember everything.
Right.
You can't separate and be like, okay, we had this interaction and that interaction is in that corner.
I got you.
And this happened and then that is in that corner. No.
I got you.
When you're trying to constantly deceive and lie, you kind of have to mesh everything together. And because men compartmentalize, that word is so hard to say today. I don't know why. They compartmentalize. That's why they can't lie good, because they forget. They forget. Mm. They put it in the corner. When she did ask me that question, and I dealt with that, and I left that. And so when we come back with that question, you don't even remember what you said at that time when we ask you the question. And so, so that's why you can't lie good, because you don't even remember what you said in the last interaction.
I have very good memory, so that won't be me.
Okay, it won't be you.
No, I don't know.
But Shakara says we're just smarter.
If I can lie, I can make sure I lie right.
Wow.
I'm trying to lie right. I can call a friend. Cause I need witnesses.
You need cover.
Yeah.
Listen,
Bob.
Call the wife. I tell her I been with you yesterday. Call her. Tell her and just ask. Tell you and talk to me and let her know. I leave my watch by you, and you can bring it later.
Wow, that's deep.
So no. You gotta be a smart liar.
Yeah. Okay.
So I think that comes to being smart.
Wow.
I guess think some men, I guess, don't in the smartest.
Wow.
But if you can lie.
No, because they've established sometimes in some instances, they've established such a relationship with their wife or whoever this partner is, they're not going to question.
Right.
Yeah. And so they don't have to go into too much depth or, you know.
Right.
But like I say, one like me, I investigate. I'm not relying on what you have to say. So when you come, you better come with all the information, because I didn't go on and look and do whatever.
Listen.
So when I asked you a question, I didn't know the answer.
Come ready.
So why don't you approach me then?
I didn't know. I will catch you.
Why you won't make me lie?
I will catch you. I don't want to make you lie, baby.
Why you won't make me lie?
I don't want to make you lie.
You won't make me
I
lie.
I want you to tell me the truth.
You won't make me lie. Just come and say why you do this.
I want you to tell me the truth. The truth.
Just say why you do this.
Ready,
I want you to tell me the truth.
Lord Jesus.
Waiting for you to lie. No, you lie.
Sheffield says, yes,
these relationships are some people crazy.
Listen, yes, a woman could be caught. When you catch her, she just pull files and start arguments, so we leave it alone.
She changed the whole topic. changed the whole topic.
You can't talk about guns.
Exactly.
Because you forget when.
In 99, when they asked you that question.
And you forget. Don't let me call.
You know what? Whatever. Fine.
Peggy said Delta getting beaten after the show. Listen to me. Listen to me.
Relationships. Oh my gosh.
I have this other thing, Delta. This is a good thing. What is it about men and the protective part of them? This is the part of a man that I don't understand because
which is a good thing.
It's a good thing. But I don't get it. What is it about men and their need to protect that you think that we don't get as women? Because I know that sometimes we push resistance against your protection, especially when it comes to you making a statement like don't bother with this person or leave that alone. Don't mess with it. Like, just leave it. Because there are times when the men in our lives will speak very firmly concerning certain things. And we can tell that it's out of protection. But we push against it. And I think we don't really have a good understanding of where it's coming from. So can you enlighten us?
I think that's back to the certain factors that are innate in men. That protector and that whole, like, if so when I say something, like, I have good reason to. And y'all listen, like, our reasoning sometimes behind it. And sometimes we don't even have a reason, just a feeling. Just a feeling of you know what?
So I think it's when women
y'all have feelings.
Oh, very, very
because
feelings-y.
We're too emotional. Why are we all in our feelings?
No, but we have feelings. We're not as emotional.
Okay.
But we definitely have feelings.
Okay. Whoa. Just a lot of stuff come in. Okay, listen.
So it's that innate quality. I don't think it's anything bad or anything. Mm-hmm. It's just an innate quality I think it's God given.
But I think those women, for whatever reason, we always tend to fight back.
You're live on Glory 93.9 FM.
Hi, good morning.
Good morning.
How you doing?
I'm doing good.
Yep.
Yeah, man, I caught the show late. I was in a session myself,
no problem.
I caught the show late. And I didn't hear a lot of what you said about what men, but I know y'all are supposed to be talking about what women need to know from men.
Yes, yes.
I heard the question you asked. Is that the pastor in the area?
No.
Oh, that's his brother.
He's a minister, though. He is minister.
Yeah, they sound so much alike.
They do.
Yeah, but I think the question you asked him is why we're so protective, which is a good question, but I think he did a good job answering that. But what are some of the other things that y'all said that women need to know about men? Because I didn't hear most of what y'all were talking about.
They need to know that we talked about affection, appreciation, sorry. That
appreciation.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that we need to say that they appreciate it. We also
mentioned
that.
Respecting opinions and
advice
to follow that, to actually take heed to some advice that's given or ask questions that you actually want to hear answers to.
Very well. And you all mentioned affection.
Talk to us about the affection thing, because I know you wanted to talk about this from last week. So go ahead. Tell us about the affection thing. Yeah, you were ready for this. I know. Go ahead.
Well, Moesha, how are you?
Moesha. I know.
You know it.
I know. Right. So go ahead. Talk to us about it.
Anyway, yeah. Affection affection for men is, I think, is number one in most cases. I think we need... What women have to understand about us and affection, because women like affection too, okay?
Uh-huh.
But women's idea of affection stops a little short of our complete need for affection.
Okay, explain that.
There are times when, for women, a cuddle is enough.
Okay.
But for men...
Okay.
In most cases.
Okay, understood.
Well, okay, yeah.
Understood.
Gotcha. So I'm trying to understand then, caller. So there is no difference between affection and being sexual for a man.
Yeah, there is. But for us men, see, when we get to that affection side of things, right? And I'm not saying for all of us. I'm speaking for me in particular.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if every man is the same way, but I can only speak for me.
Correct.
And I know a lot of our men feel the same way.
Correct.
The affection side, when we get to affection, it goes a little further. Our feelings begin to become aroused.
Okay.
And if we stop short of the rest.
Understood. Got
it. Yeah.
Absolutely got it.
That's what the young lady asked. Yeah, it's different, you know. I could lay in bed and cuddle with you all night. It's just that I'm expecting to go a little further after all of that cuddling.
Yeah.
You understand? Because our minds go there.
Okay.
And if you have the type of wife that is right there, when I say right there, she got it all.
Right.
Mm-hmm. And you have the feelings, you say, boy, this is the best woman I've ever had in my entire life, and I don't want nothing else. We're going further.
Understood.
We're going further. We want to go a little further. And women need to understand that. Women think cuddling is enough. No.
It's enough for her.
Okay, so how many people in there?
We're talking about what we need to know, Italia. They saying it's not enough.
It's not enough.
Okay.
It's not enough.
How many people in the bed, in the room? Let me say in the room. How many people in the room?
Not enough. It's just, it's not enough.
It's two people.
You know what? If I were my married self, which I'm not, but if I were my married self, I totally agree with you.
Yeah, you gotta think, okay, I know love is important. We need to show that kind of love. We need to express that in a good way. We need to talk, yes. We need to have that conversation. We need to make sure that things are in place.
Okay.
All right? And if we want to go further, yes, then there's a lot of things that we have to do.
Okay.
To ensure that the woman's needs are met as well. The women's needs are being met.
Right.
If one of those things are in place, there should be no reason why the affection shouldn't go further.
Okay. So are you saying, from your perspective, that making sure that there is sexual satisfaction in a marriage is how a man receives affection from a woman?
Okay, it's like I'm saying, right? I'm saying if you are as a man, I know that my wife loves the affection.
Right.
She loves the cuddling.
Right.
All right? Okay. So in order for me to get what I want from the cuddling and the affection, I have to make certain that everything is in place. It goes beyond just sex, you know? It gets to the point.
Okay, I understand what you're saying.
Yeah, but you make certain that everything is in place. You have a happy woman, you have a happy home, you have a happy husband.
Got you. Thank you so much for your comments.
Yeah.
Interesting.
Yeah. Y'all have a good day, man.
You too,
thank
sir.
You so much.
All right, bye-bye.
All right.
Yeah.
There you go.
So
I'll jump on.
Yeah.
From what he's talking about.
Yes.
There's a balance that has to happen, especially for married people, where it's like emotional and sexual, right? I think the affection side of it, the affection side of it is like the emotional side of it. For females, if you can satisfy the emotional side of it, it can lead to sexual activity.
Yeah, I agree.
For men, you a piece of sexual first, and that leads to our emotion. Mm. So we are vice versa. So
that's like it's a total
opposite.
So who goes first? The chicken or the egg? Who goes first? Do you satisfy me first?
For the sad part of, I mean, not sad part, for the most part of it, we have to satisfy y'all first.
Yeah.
And it's not. It doesn't really happen a lot. That's why a lot of women are frustrated, I guess, with a lot of men. And I can speak personally. I am not, I mean, to talk about the whole five love languages thing, I am not a person of physical touch. Mm-hmm. I don't do PDA.
Oh.
I don't do public display of affection. Mm-hmm. That ain't really my forte. I can do it, but it's not like, so I don't like people touching me. Like, that's all the world. Don't touch me. Don't touch me. So that's not my area, but I have to force it just to meet the satisfaction of a woman.
Yeah.
And so
that's interesting.
So you learn to get the emotional side of a female, learn to massage that right, and then you get to my fellow male caller.
I mean,
Lord Jesus.
What was
that? I got a lot of comments.
You know, the fact that for the woman you need to address her emotional state, and then once you understand that she's happy emotionally, that it could lead to other things.
Yeah. But for
a man, it's the opposite.
It's the opposite. Yeah, I can get sexually happy. Oh, man, listen to me. I love you to pieces. Oh,
We talk about everything and anything.
That's just me. Let's talk.
All of a sudden,
about?
You have air. You
Ooh,
can be that air.
Listen to me. We sit down. We talk. What you want to talk about? We just talk. You just talk. I just hear for you. You just talk, but I listen. I hold your hand. Listen to me, man. We go to long walks on the beach. Yeah, whatever you want to do. That's what to make you happy.
This is powerful.
I just want to make you happy.
We just need to find our own flow.
You got to find a balance.
Wow.
I want to get some more comments in here. Vera says, is affection always displayed physically? Are there any other ways?
Of course you can show it other ways. It's
for
not
men. You can't.
Oh,
for you can say that for
Sorry.
You, Italia.
Sorry! Yeah, for men.
No, I think we view affection as physical touch.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Mm. That's basically, essentially. Yeah. Now, interesting because
that's what he was saying, too.
Yeah. Another male is saying here. I don't even know how to read this comment on AL. You show all of this affection. It's time to dance. This is powerful.
It's time to dance.
But on the real, he's saying that sex is not needed all the time. That's interesting. And then he's laughing at my facial expression. Well, I can't say everything else that he said here because I mean I can't. But that's really awesome that you do that for your wife, Sheffield.
Going dead.
That's really good. And Delton, someone made a comment and they says when they see you again, they're going to tickle you.
Do not touch me, please.
I'm not gonna say who it is.
Let me see myself.
They said they're gonna kill you. That's powerful. Okay, I think that we've learned a lot. I've definitely learned a lot today, and I do have two more questions that I kind of want to throw at Delton. I don't know if you have any more. Tell you. Do you have anything?
No,
okay,
kind of piggyback up.
I have two more questions. I have another question. The way that women prepare females, mm-hmm. we prepare for marriage all of our lives.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. If we're having a sober conversation here, from the moment we have Ken and Barbie, we're preparing for this relationship all of our lives. What is it about men that they can actually function and that's not even a part of their thought process? Until a certain point in time,
because we don't get Ken and Bowie, we get trucks to fix, we get tools, get things put together. You buy your son a hammer and screwdriver. You buy your son things to fix things. that's what you do. Like you don't
that's right.
you don't treat your, you don't get your meals ready for the whole marriage aspect of it.
Wow, that's interesting.
And even for most men, even if you have the nuclear family, you have the father and the mother at home.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of men, I guess, my father is older.
Mm-hmm.
That generation, they don't talk about it. They just live it out. And so you get to see like how this whole marriage things work. But you don't say sit down and talk about it.
No.
You ain't talking about it.
Right.
So you just do what you see me do.
Mm-hmm.
And so for one, we don't know what it is for our light and water to cut off. That's stuff daddies do. You know, grocery license, that's what daddy does. But to say, talk about that marriage aspect of it and this is what you expect, this is what you're going for, that discussion don't happen. That not that I can think of with men until you find somebody and you know what? I think I'm getting married. And so now it's like, all right, so what is marriage about? That's why for females y'all have your color scheme and thing and they're ready to go.
Yeah.
And for us, we be like
still trying to
I get on two from buttons and I'd be good to go.
Right. I've actually found that not all females are like that. I thought they were, but there are some females
who
very few.
It's few.
My wife was one of them. She didn't have that plan from she was young.
Me neither. I didn't have a plan.
She didn't have that plan. So color scheme.
Perfect example.
Yeah. So it's not all. It's definitely not all.
No, I didn't have a plan from
her. I think majority has that little.
But I do have one comment I'd like to make.
Go ahead, sure.
Based on one of my viewers, Leonardo Todd. I think that's my high school classmate.
Mm-hmm.
He says one of the most important thing women need to know is that. A man
talking to Mike. Sorry, Italia, so we can clear.
One of the most important things women need to know is that a man defines love as respect.
That's good.
Yeah,
I hear that a lot. Like respect, yeah. Mm-hmm. respect.
What does respect look like, Delton?
back to what I'm saying.
Yeah.
It's just saying, like, when you ask me something, you take, like, you listen to me when I talk to you.
I mean, like, I find that it's like yeah, up here
no,
up for men.
Yeah, no, that's up there.
Wow.
Again, that's another innate thing. That's just in us. Like, and that's how we function.
Mm.
Like, we need that. We need to know that you respect
and
us.
And the lack of it causes you to dysfunction.
Do men consider the fact that though that for women we need to see something to respect.
That is true as well.
Mm.
So,
but regardless of if you don't see it, we still want it.
What?
Yeah. That's the side. But that's the whole definition of something being innate. Like, wow, that's just my nature. So regardless,
whether or not
I am respect worthy,
wow,
I still expect you to respect.
I don't want to be mad. You don't do nothing for me to respect you, but you want me to respect you.
Because my nature is I want respect.
And you know my mode is sharp.
Listen. Listen to me.
Two-edged sword.
Because I'm
Shabadana, two-edged sword.
If you have done nothing, like absolutely nothing to earn my respect, what?
Oh my God.
No,
That's the Christian thing, Mauricio.
The Christian thing is to still respect them, eh? Mm-hmm. Well, the world say you want respect, give it.
Mm. Yeah.
That's hard.
That's what the world say. You know. Lord Jesus, I'm supposed to be a believer. I don't know that.
I'm supposed to be.
No, I had to listen. I had to bring myself back. I had to come back. No, because I had, sometimes, you know, your mind is drift into these situations.
Easy.
Oh my gosh. Like, saying, how do you want me? You have done everything to disrespect me, and now you want me to turn around and respect you?
Are you
kidding me? Jesus hung on the cross, not Mauricio. Jesus did. Sorry. I apologize.
Have your clothes left? No.
You don't respect me. No, I don't, because you didn't do anything for me to respect you.
My God.
You didn't respect me first.
How you get with him then?
Jesus.
These are things you see afterwards.
Afterwards.
You think so?
This is what has happened afterwards.
Yeah, man.
Yeah.
Some people side good, but
There's lie.
I know.
Lie
now,
and
here's
Ben.
The thing.
Ben the truth.
Ben the truth.
They're like Ben.
I think a lot of times people think no. I don't know if it's that.
You've been giving people the benefit of the doubt.
Yeah,
man.
And then when they do that to me, I didn't get the benefit of the doubt. You saw who I was. You just chose to ignore it.
Wow.
You saw me.
Wow.
you saw exactly what you saw, but you saw something that you liked.
It hurt.
I know, right?
You saw the color of the skin. You saw the body that you wanted. You saw the height that you wanted.
Everything.
You saw what you wanted. So then I didn't change. You just ignoring that factor because you saw. You got a little like yeah, yeah. So you ignore that because listen to me.
This is what you wanted.
This is what I wanted, yeah.
That hurt.
Someone that, you know what? This right here, this is who I can see myself with. Literally see. It's like this physical. This is who I can see myself with. So, you know, I think a lot of times in relationships, we choose to ignore what we want to.
Not benefit of them.
But Dalton, how do you... How do you choose what to accept? Like, this is always the question that I have as a single person, because at some point in time when you're getting to know somebody, you will see things that you don't like.
Mm-hmm.
You will see things that you're like, boy, I don't know if I can handle that. But then you don't want to be like, okay, well, then I'm done.
Total dismissive.
Yeah, like you don't want to do that. Because then how do you know that? First of all, most times when we do that, when we get to that totally dismissive place, we haven't even had a conversation with the person about this thing that they've done, right?
Correct.
So that's the first thing. Mm-hmm. And then the second thing is we're viewing the thing that they did or their response or their lack thereof or whatever it is, we're viewing it from our perspective through mm-hmm. our own personal mm-hmm. filters. So we don't have an understanding why they did what they did. And you don't necessarily want to come right out when you get to know somebody and be like, okay, so why did you do this? You know, like you know, like a pushy, inquisitive way.
If
like,
there's something that you see a future with, you have to do that, though. If there's someone that you're thinking, like,
right,
future
based. Right, so the plan is to eventually do it.
I think we just, I think we quote unquote love too quickly. You know, kind of
I think so. I think that, like, you can.
And because of that, we mm-hmm. end up closing eyes to certain things, like you say, or, you know, when we should be asking and being and looking and questioning and being critical and whatnot, we love too quickly. Because once that love come in there, we kind of, everything looks so off.
I get skewed. Everything's get skewed. And, like, oh,
and then,
that's
the
one.
You know,
yes.
When, because I only can speak from my experience. There have been times when I would point out something. I'd be like, why do you do that? And they'd be like, I'm not like that all the time.
Oh, that's a lie.
Oh, my gosh.
that's a lie.
Oh my gosh. And then, so, you know, how do you determine when to walk away? Like, how do you establish that? Like, you understand what I'm saying? So it's kind of a, like a, and I ain't gonna lie. Can I just want to say this out in the open. If y'all judge me, too bad. I really wish I was an unsaved person who found somebody and then both of us got saved together. Because let me tell you what's a part of my difficulty as a believer. Mm-hmm. One of my difficulties as a believer is that I feel like I have a responsibility to extend grace to people. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And not just be like, oh, well, this person is the devil, so walk away. Or look at their flaws and be like, oh, I just need to throw you away because you're just trash. But like Vera say, you shouldn't be given the benefit of the doubt. You should earn it. But I am a giving the benefit of the doubt person. Mm-mm. Dalton say, don't do that.
No.
Especially when it comes to men. Because what we see is what we get. And a spade is a spade.
Pretty much. Pretty much.
Holy
but
that's, ghost.
But that's what you see is what you get. That whole idea of... And we always say, but like, you can change. There's not going to, no. And you can't change me, though.
Communication.
And the same thing, we can't change y'all, either. No. It's not going to happen.
You don't think y'all could change us?
No.
Why is he change?
I was just going to say, I have been in a relationship where a man has changed me before. And I have watched my friends change.
In terms of what? When you say change, what do we call change?
Even something as simple as some of the things that I used to like. I don't like him no more because you don't like him.
Yeah, I don't put on makeup because he say.
Yeah, so I stopped putting on makeup.
He don't like me with makeup.
Yeah.
Blah, 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 blah,
don't
blah.
Wear weave because he don't like you wearing weave. So I changed from wearing weave. He don't like your nails long. Wear them short. I changed my nails to wear them short.
I mean, I've never done that.
See, like, I don't think it's something you would do. Oh, sorry, yeah, that. I apologize.
Dalton says he apologized on behalf of his species.
That we made you.
Lord God.
I can give you stuff that I like, but I'm not going to tell you change it.
Yeah, that's crazy.
So I can offer, like, I give suggestions, but to make you change it, no.
Liz says, don't ignore the red flags when you see them.
It's not a red flag. If I make a change, red flag.
Don't ignore the red flags when you see them in the beginning of a relationship. You must address them immediately. Mm-hmm. Nicole says, communication is key. Peggy says, do it right away. No problems later.
Yep.
Cass says she agrees. There's a lot of agreement here.
Yeah. Mm-mm. No benefit of
it. Sheffield says, yo, if she is worth it, men change. You can change a woman. Especially if she really loves you. I agree with you, Sheffield. Delton doesn't. I believe if that woman really listen to me, Delton. When a woman really, really love you,
I don't think it'll be long term.
They are who they are.
After a while, if I tell you I don't like wearing makeup, at some point you'll be like, you know what, I feel like wearing makeup today, and you can go out, and then somebody can see you like it, and you'll be like, you know what, I like makeup again, because like you always like makeup. So you could change temporarily and just a piece, but I don't think that's going to be long term.
Nicole says, I think she means women. Women change for betterment. Men change for the right woman.
Say that again, men.
Women change for betterment. Mm-hmm. Men change for the right woman.
I try my best to go after Jesus. I had the same today. Yesterday, fair from all. What you see is what you get. What you see is what you get.
Oh,
I don't,
my gosh. Okay. All right, my last question as we wrap this up.
Yeah.
As we wrap this up, my last question is this. What is the number one thing that you think that women misunderstand about men? The number one thing. If you could, you know, pause for a moment, think about all of the disagreements that you would have had with the females in your life, the females you would have had encounters with, or any, maybe somebody else's situation you may have observed and you was like, I could relate to this dude or whatever. What is the number one thing that you think women need to know about men if we haven't covered it already? Or maybe we have, I don't know.
It sort of goes back to something we talked about before.
Okay.
I think one of the things that women oftentimes like go past of it is that men really, we need to be loved too.
Men need love too.
Men need love.
Hashtag. Men need,
it's because men are feelings. men are feelingsy. We're not as feelingsy, but we are feelings.
Okay.
So I think a lot of women sometimes can approach men as these just this masculine. It's either it's all man or just one sex. There's no in between. Mm-hmm. But I think a lot of men, because they lack that in between, that's where they get that the two extremes from.
Okay.
Because they don't get that love and affection kind of thing.
They take the really. I want this is coming to my head. As far as relationship goes, we always tend to say, or think. I think that women take it more serious than men.
Yeah.
But you say men.
No, just, men take it seriously.
They're just as involved and connected and.
Just as involved, just as much want to please you as you want to please them. Now I can say that some this y'all men are like this, but some women have caused men to become that quote unquote dog character that they oftentimes label as.
Yeah, no, we do
a
that.
Lot of women have turned men into these quote-unquote animals because they found somebody who they was like really in love with, and that person just like crush on, step all over it. So it's like, oh, this ain't happen again.
You need to learn how to forgive.
Yay. All right. So what happened?
Okay.
Moving along. And so what usually happened is that ain't happened again, and so... And then, so the next person,
heart.
Like, there's an example I can give you where I was always, I mean, and this goes back to what I was saying, Marisha, like, you could change, but you didn't change for long. Where right. I was upset, like, I used to give this girl everything, anything she wanted, how about here you go. And that then, to the next person I was in a relationship with, I can tell you the one thing I bought them.
Wow.
I literally can tell you the one thing that I bought that person. And we was talking for like a couple months. Like, the one thing was cost me like $1.79.
Oh my gosh, Delta.
Which is like a cup of mint chocolate ice cream from Lickley Split the on Village Road.
Poor child.
I can tell you the one thing. But however, and like innate me, like the net after a while, like that just, I couldn't keep that going because I didn't meet.
Right. So you're working from a place of hurt.
Yeah. So, and unfortunately, some men can, they can keep that hurt going for a long time.
Yeah, people hold on cold. Wow.
So it's so bad. So they keep that hurt going for a long time. That just never changes again. And so then you end up with the person that you call a dog and it's cheating, it's lying. It's really, yes.
Wow.
He's a broken person in need of love, love and affection to get him to that place where he can go back to who he truly is.
Is there any general way that you would say all men need to be loved in this way, or do you think it's a specific individual thing?
I think it's individualized.
Okay.
I don't think everybody has their different, like, go back to the five, these love languages.
Right.
And everybody interprets love differently.
Definitely.
And so I can't say this is the general way.
Right.
So yeah, man, make sure I tell him stuff.
Man.
Yeah. Tell him stuff, because that can make
gotta
him know.
Gotta go to school. We said that last
yeah.
week.
Yeah. You have to learn. Those love languages, learn it, whether he likes acts of kindness, I mean acts of service, whatever those the other five is. I remember them. But you have to, everybody has their one week, so you gotta be intentional in learning how your man needs that love.
I ain't gonna lie, Dalton, I like you, I little salty too. I buy things too.
Yeah.
And unlike you, I'm not over it.
So you buy human nothing?
I buy anything.
No.
Yeah. No, because I buy Delta knows.
I like to give gifts.
Italia, I buy things. I listen to me. I ain't talking about cheap things, you know.
Yeah.
I'm talking about like hundreds of dollars things.
That's a bit much though.
Anyway, that's another conversation.
That's
another
topic for another day. That's
yeah, we need to have that conversation.
Hundreds.
I talk about stuff that costs money, like $300
Whoa.
Things.
Yeah, no.
Because this is what you need to make your dreams happen.
Oh yeah. Yeah, no.
I think I did that once with my husband when we were dating.
By a boat?
By a boat?
He bought him a boat?
What? No.
My God!
I Lord saw that he was trying to do something.
It's a fire.
It was something. He was trying to do something, and I saw what he was trying to do.
Mm.
And that one time I really went, and I went a little overboard. And I gave him something significant.
Dalton, fix this. Time. Fix this. Talk to us, because
one time.
These niggas, and let's tell the truth. these sorry, I shouldn't say that on the radio.
These
I apologize.
Negro gentlemen.
These black men.
Yeah. But no.
These black men. I apologize. I repent for those who are listening on the radio. I should not have said that word.
Negro gentlemen.
These men are spending our money as women, and they are driving our vehicles, and we trying to make everything happen. Talk to us.
Whoa, who's that person?
Oh, so y'all put down like y'all don't see this.
Oh yeah, we said, but no.
Yeah. Oh no, I thought someone was like, come on, man, and ask a question.
No,
that person needs to stop.
No.
And value yourself.
I know, right?
That's what you need to do. You need to value yourself.
Mm-hmm, that makes
sure. For you to be supporting
a no good
person.
So we don't help men at all. That's what you're saying. Don't help.
You help, but you don't aid. You don't like aid them in that situation.
What's the difference?
Aid is like where I want to keep you where you are. Because if you're not seeing any, this is like he ain't driving your car to try to look for a job. He driving your car to go chill.
Thank you.
No, that's a problem.
That's a problem.
Now, if you take my car and you're going out and you want to hunt, you're trying to work, you're trying to do something, then mm-hmm. of course you can borrow the car because then you're trying to better yourself. But if you got a guy who just says, taking your money,
he drop you to work,
and when you come back home, like you don't even see that no difference. He ain't even clean the house. He ain't do nothing. He just driving around chilling with the boys.
That's a problem.
And then when he pick you up, the car low on gas, so you need gas money. No, you got a little boy. You use a mummy.
Ooh.
You know, and you're not ready for a relationship. You got a child with you that you're trying to take care of. Yeah.
We gotta go. No, we all got.
So you got a child. You got a child you're trying to take care of, and that you need to stop now.
Okay.
That's not your son.
Wow.
I see.
That's not your son.
Not your son.
Not
hashtag.
Your son.
Two hashtags for the day.
That's not your
man
son.
Man have feelings too. Hashtag not your son.
That's not your son.
Not your son.
Wow.
Not your son. Listen, these comments have been crazy. I really wish I could have gotten all of them in. This show, I think this show needs a part two because I really want to get our other two guests who were supposed to be here today on. I really think that they have a lot to contribute to this conversation. One of them is married, the other one is divorced and now single, which is why I really wanted him to talk about it because I feel like he has a lot of different perspectives, and so I think we need to do a part two. So we're gonna try and line it up. We're not gonna be in studio next week Monday because it's a holiday.
Woo-hoo.
So happy early birthday, Delton.
Woo!
Happy early birthday. But I think when we come back, Italia, we agree we need to do a part two of this.
Agree.
We need to do a part two of this.
This is good.
And
we need to rush the conversation.
Yes. We don't want to rush this because we want to make sure that we benefit from it. Okay, somebody being petty and say, get that comment in before I go. So let me do that because I don't want people to catch feelings. Being submissive doesn't make you a weak woman. That's the comment that they wanted us to get in. And you know what? Mr. Adderley, we actually talked about that last week. And we actually said that as women, we have no problem submitting. Just give us something to submit to.
But it's a two-way street. We submit to one another.
Yes, we submit to one another. But women, we want a vision to come underneath.
Submission.
We want something to submit to. So don't just tell me that I'm supposed to submit to you because you are a man. No, it's not going to work. Just because you name man? No. Give me something. Something more than that. Just because you're born male doesn't mean that as a woman I have to submit to you. There needs to be something else. Am I wrong for saying that, Delton?
No.
Okay, that's good.
That's correct.
Good. So, so this has been a really, really good show. My phone is continuing to go off and all kind of stuff, but I'm just going to shut this down right here. So, people, we will see you guys not this coming Monday, but next week, Monday, for another episode of Girl Talk Today. We talked about what women need to know about men. Part two is coming your way 2 Mondays from now. Y'all have a blessed day. And listen, for the married people, y'all listen to each other and go to school, eh? For the single people, I don't know what to say but us today. So I just delete that right there. Because they really ain't give us no hope today. They just tell us, drop everybody. So y'all just get rid of everybody.
Just drop everybody.
All right, y'all. We gone. Bye.